If during lockdown you tried a bit of cycling and you want to take it to the next stage, well, I have the right person here with me. This is Eoghan McHugh, and Eoghan, you're proposing some, well, a real challenge to people who want to cycle beyond their comfort zone. Is that right?
Yeah. Everyone is interested or is invited. So September 20th, I'm doing something called Everesting on Firle Beacon.
And Everesting comes from the word Everest.
Mount Everest.
Which scares me already.
Don't be.
Right.
You don't need to be intimidated necessarily, because intimidation might mean that you don't come out. But the challenge, and it's a personal challenge, is the Everesting, and it's a comparison. So you pick a hill anywhere and you cycle it as many times as it takes to cycle the equivalent height of Mount Everest, which is 8,848 meters.
Ah, easy.
No problem for you, right? I mean, you just started. I mean, you've been.
I told you that I took my bike twice last week from my house, which is not far from the pier, to the pier and back. So, could I do it? Could I do some of it? Are you welcoming any ability, any age?
Anybody. And look, I don't mind if people don't even bring their bikes. Like, for me, the whole idea is I'm going to be doing this personal challenge, and it's something for me to take off the box. But there's so. In effect, kind of the way I think of it is, it's sort of like sharing. So I've spent hours and hours and hours on the South Downs. I know it's beautiful. I've spent hours and hours and hours through East and West Sussex. And I know there's a lot of great people in East and West Sussex. So for me and my approach with this event, I'm inviting people out so that they can see the same sort of things that I get to see, which is East and West Sussex is a great community, full of awesome people with different stories like yourself and everyone else. And when they get up onto the Downs as well, it's just so beautiful that, there's that sort of sense of appreciation of the community that we live in and the wonderful area that we live in. So I don't mind if people don't bring their bikes, come do whatever it is that you want, come bring the kids, bring a picnic, bring the dog, whatever. A friend of mine who runs a coffee truck, he's going to be there for the day as well. So there's going to be a coffee truck there
okay.
on the day.
And obviously there is a positive, good agenda also, because money will be, or you're hoping to get some money for a charitable cause. Do you want to tell me a bit about that?
Yeah. So hoping to raise some money for Surface Against Sewage. They're a UK-based charity, and they work towards cleaning and preserving waterways through the UK. But, I mean, the going back to the kind of communal focus to it too, I'm hoping that people, when they come off the hill, just feel good. So they whether
they... Or tired.
Or whether they feel tired or whether they feel good, but, you know, that they've got to forget about some of their problems for the last couple of months, or in your case, when you come and do two or three reps, and I never knew I could do that, yet you do it and you kind of get swept up in the atmosphere. Wow, how awesome for me as a personal kind of empowerment. And then also then, you know, how beautiful it is. So again, those three different things, if people kind of come out and experience that, and then yes, of course, that kind of translates across into the charity and Surface Skin Search.
And with all due respect to the Downs, they're not quite the Everest. So what's the idea to kind of cycle
up and down? Yeah. So for me, I'm going to be there from about midnight on the 20th and just go for however long it takes. So it's 66 reps for me to do. 12 to 15 hours is kind of the expectation as to how long it would take.
Right, okay. And when you say expectation, I mean, you might come with slightly different standards, because my colleague Mark Walker interviewed you on The Vote, and you talked about your cycling, was it 700 miles or thereabouts in Morocco, in the
That's
desert?
Right. Yeah.
So this will be a different experience, obviously.
Yeah. And I mean, like I said, I've spent a ton of time up in the Downs. With lockdown, I was on there on my bike as it is. So I've done the single a couple of times, so from Eastbourne across to Winchester, had a bit of fun with that. In July, I tried to do the South Downs Way double, which is you do 200 miles. So the whole challenge is 200 miles, 24 hours or less. And that's all off-road for the most part. And I got 178 miles into it at hour 23 or whatever. But this challenge is completely different. And what's different about it and is unique is you start at the bottom of the hill, you go to the top of the hill, you turn around, you come back down, and it's just rinse and repeat until you're finished, both figuratively and literally.
Okay.
Because figuratively, you're going to be wiped by
yes.
the end of
but a good experience, I'm sure. How can people contact you if they wish to take part?
Yeah, so I've got a Facebook event page and I've created it so that, again, people can kind of keep tabs on what's going on, when things are happening, and make sure as well, if they are actually interested, that they have the reminder.
And the name of the Facebook
page? It's Everesting Cycling Firle Beacon 66 times. So, you know, exactly as it says on the tin, try to keep the details as it is. So,
great.
Yeah.
Oh, and thank you so much for coming, and good luck.
Well, don't wish me luck, because I'll see you on the day. But thank you very
we
much.
We may do. Bye.